representing the ninth group. So good evening and Jesu to all. As we know, today we are gathered here to report of 3 days on the workshop of evangelization. I am not going to tell about everything, but what I and my group members have received and what the word touched us. So in the beginning of the workshop on 29th, we have started the workshop with the word of God, that He called us, He gave us, and He sent us. As a missionary, we must believe it. Brother Thomas Paul said on the first day that we become a missionary when we receive the baptism. It is the duty of all the Christians to proclaim the word of God to the peoples and bring near the peoples to God. God says, as you go, proclaim the good news, the kingdom of heaven has come near. Matthew chapter 10, verse 7. Second, brother told and took the 2 candles, one red and one white. The red one, he told us, as the red one is Jesus and the white we ourselves. He told that Jesus is the light of the world, and you take this white candle as I myself is the light of the world. So it is not that only God is the light of the world. Every human being has the capacity, and with the belief and with the help of the Holy Spirit, we can do great things. And as God did, we can also become the light of the world. And He showed us the action and told us that this is God and this is human being. When the God comes and He mix with the human being, then when we become together, then we become more powerful, and as God became man, we become God. That is a grace for all of us. And we also heard that we can become the another Christ, as we call Saint Francis of Assisi as another Christ. We can also develop and make our faith strong and believe, and we can be another Christ, so that by our life others can experience God's love. Corinthians chapter 13 verse 2, it is said, and if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains but do not love, I am nothing. So to become another Christ, the prime duty is to love one another, because Jesus taught us to love one another. In the New Testament we can see about the love of Jesus. And on the third day, on the second day, we started with the grace. Brother told us about what is grace. Do anyone know? So he told us that grace is a participation of human life into divine life. And we proceeded further, and we were preparing ourselves to see the visions. It was a great experience for me, so that I never thought that I can also see visions for someone else. But brother guided us, helped us, and he taught us that how can you see the vision. He told you can see the darkness or a water, some words or some elements, so that I got the belief, and I also thought to see the vision for someone And when we were kneeling down and praying for one another, I also got 5-6 visions, and it was somewhere right and somewhere wrong. He told that it is a great thing when we reported about the group activity. Then he told that now it is so good, so we can pray to the Holy Spirit that we can get the interpretation of the Holy, means that vision. And we tried that, and I think that all of us passed, and we, by the help of the Holy Spirit, we did it. Brother told us that our vocation itself is a charism. So, as I was going to pray and see the vision, I was thinking that after praying and getting the vision, I thought that I also got the I also got the charism of the Holy Spirit to see the vision for another. But once brother also told that your vocation itself is a charism of the Holy Spirit. And he also told to ponder on the picture of the Pentecost. So one of our group members, she saw and she noticed that, and she felt and she thought to believe like them. And he told, we live in a sinful world, isn't it? But brother gave the example of lotus, that the lotus dwells in the dirty water but shines. And it is the national flower. So we can also become like a lotus in our life, because it is written in the letter of Paul to the Philippians, chapter 4, verse 13. I can do all things through him who strengthens me. We must have a personal word of God, so that our belief should be depended on that word of God. And as brother said, Romans chapter 8 verse 31, if God is for us, who is against us? This is the word of God of our brother Thomas Paul, what keeps him so strong and energetic. Even though his age is 73, he is with a strong energy and fulfilled with the Holy Spirit, and here he is preaching us and giving us a good workshop. So let us also have a personal word of God. And on the third day, when we proceeded today, he told us about the 8 mysteries of the Holy Eucharist. Maybe it is first time for all of us to know about the Holy Eucharist, that incarnation, baptism, and death, passion, death and resurrection, second coming. This everything is new for us, that we can see in the Holy Eucharist. From the birth of Jesus till his second coming, there is everything present in the Holy Eucharist. This we came to know through the preaching of our brother Thomas Paul. So I thank you, brother, for giving us such a knowledge. And he told us that in the liturgy, there are 3 main points. Christ manifests, he makes himself present, and he communicates. And he told us about the transformation. He took the parables from the Gospel of St. John, and he explained us very well about each and every parable. So they all are events. So it is our duty to transform ourselves. We will be transformed when we are together with the God, the Holy Trinity. And he told us about the personal prayer. The personal prayer is also the one way to transform our life. So let us take the decision to make a personal prayer every day. So I will share some of the things that I have came from my seat to here. I was very afraid of coming here. I was seeing when my number will come. And at last, it was my number. I prayed to the Holy Spirit and I told God to help me. And if I have done any mistake, please forgive me. And when I was climbing the steps till I reached here, I was very afraid. And I thought that what I wrote, that I will present here. But after coming to the dais and seeing the audience and preaching, not preaching but reporting, I felt very happy. Means I did not read from here. Some of the things I told from my own, that I thought that Holy Spirit helped me a lot. So I also take the opportunity to thank our brother. So let us clap the hands and thank our brother. And let us praise the God, and I will end my report here. Hallelujah! 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 Thank you.